very much believe in an open internet, and we practice what we believe. We have embraced and were in fact among some early technology companies that helped to feed into the FCC's principles, pro-consumer principles around choice there, namely that users should have the final say in their internet experience, whether it's what device, what application, what service provider to use, what hardware to use. We believe that the future growth of the web requires advanced and open networks and incentives for investment and innovation. So it's usually the pairing of those words, investment and innovation. And that for government policy, flexibility is key. That providers should have the ability to manage their networks, that we should do it reasonably, consistent with customers' preferences, and not unreasonably discriminate in ways that harm users or are anti-competitive. And we should have the freedom to offer managed network services. Now, what I've just summarized was actually of some interest to people who follow this, because in October, this was the subject of a joint statement by the CEO of Verizon Wireless and the CEO of Google. And Google's usually seen as a strong proponent for some kind of interventionist net neutrality policy. But I think what this actually represents is a search for a common ground, if we can find it, to try to come up with an outcome that balances the many different considerations here.